What's interesting is that when we talk about sexual freedom, culture tells us that watching porn is a good thing and it helps you discover and explore your sexuality. Pop singer Billie Eilish also used to hold this view, but says that her views have since changed. In a recent interview, she talked about how watching porn actually damaged her mental health, and a lot of other celebrities have had similar stories. But let's go ahead and start with Billie's. Howard Stern was interviewing Billie Eilish when she said this: "As a woman, I think porn is a disgrace, and I used to watch a lot of porn, to be honest. I started watching porn when I was like 11. I didn't understand why it was a bad thing. I thought that's how you learned how to have sex. I was an advocate, and I thought I was one of the guys, and would talk about it and think I was really cool for not having a problem with it and not seeing why it was bad. And I think it really destroyed my brain, and I feel incredibly devastated that I was exposed to so much porn." And then she goes on to say, "I'm so angry that porn is so loved, and I'm so angry at myself for thinking that it was okay." So as we just heard, Billie used to be an advocate for porn, and she thought that she was more free than others because she accepted porn, but then she came to realize that porn actually damaged her mental health. But Billie's not alone here. The actor Orlando Bloom also similarly enjoyed his freedom to watch porn until he realized that porn kept him from connecting to women on a friendship level. He talked about this, and he also said, "When you watch multiple people at multiple times in one evening, how is your actual real life partner going to match up?" He goes on to say, "Porn is super disruptive to your sex life and your libido." Ex-football player and actor Terry Crews also talked about how he saw porn as freeing until he realized how much it came between him and his wife. He said, "My wife was literally like, I don't know you anymore, and I'm out of here. And that changed me, because you realize, yo, this is a major, major problem. I literally had to go to rehab for it." He also says pornography changes the way you think about people. People become objects, people become body parts. They become things to be used rather than people to be loved. And Russell Brand, a once sexual activist, now has several videos and talks as an anti-porn advocate. For Russell, sex and porn not only messed up his marriage with Katy Perry, but also led to a whole host of other issues surrounding intimacy and trust. And we also have several more stories like these, from John Mayer to Chris Rock, Hugh Grant, Kanye West, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, and plenty of others. Now, what's so interesting about these stories is that, like most people in culture today, so many of us believe that by exploring porn and by having sexual freedom, that it would lead to us feeling liberated and feeling free. But in reality, as we just heard, instead of finding sexual freedom, they found sexual slavery. They were no longer able to enjoy sex with their spouse, they were no longer able to get aroused, they were no longer able to have healthy bonds and relationships, and a host of other mental health issues as well. Now keep in mind, almost everyone that we mentioned, to the best of my knowledge, aren't Christians, but their experiences validate what Paul was talking about in the Bible when he talked about choosing what you'll be a slave to. When it comes to the idea of slavery, when we're compelled to give something our attention and it constantly occupies our minds, then we become slaves to that thing. Paul argues that being slaves to sin only ends in bad outcomes that you don't want. Because as countless studies have shown, when it comes to being a slave to porn, there's no good outcome that comes from it. It doesn't help your life, and it will only lead to troubles and disappointments that will give you an overall lower quality of life. Again, outcomes that you don't want. But the same thing is true when we choose to be slaves to righteousness. When we choose to focus our minds on that, it leads to outcomes that you do want. And I talk about some of those outcomes in this video, so go ahead and click here and I'll see you over there. But the next time you hear that porn leads to sexual freedom, what are you gonna say? What do you mean?